Hi you guys, Lindsay here. Welcome back to my channel, Inside the Hem.
Trick or treat. Today I'm revealing my Halloween outfit made from Butterick 6621 and the free skirt pattern from Megan Nielsen, the Veronika skirt. Okay, let's save the best for last and talk about the Veronika skirt first. I actually made this a couple of years ago. The Veronika is a free sewing pattern from Megan Nielsen Patterns. You can download it for free by signing up for her newsletter. She describes it as a basic full circle skirt for woven or stretch fabrics. The pattern features optional roomy scalloped pockets and two waistband choices. Version 1 is for woven fabrics and includes scalloped pockets and a wide waistband. Version 2 is for woven fabrics and includes a narrow waistband. Version 3 is for stretch fabrics. It's rated a skill level of 1 out of 5 and comes in sizes extra small through extra large. The fabric I used is a pleather I got from one of my earlier trips to the New York City Garment District. The pattern is perfect for tricky fabrics like this because there are so few seams, no darts, pleats, or gathers, and bonus, you can skip the hem on pleather. Okay, now that that is out of the way, let's talk about this adorable top. The pattern is Butterick 6621. It's described as a close-fitting knit dress with front, neckline, and sleeve variations and double-stitched hems. Views B and C have ties that are single thickness and the wrong side of the fabric may show. I made view A with the twist front, shortened it into a top, lined the bodice, skipped the sleeve hems, and then tucked it into the high-waisted skirt for a messy tucked-in look. The pattern is deceptively simple to sew. The knot is really just a twist, and the instructions are super clear. To line it, I used the same bodice pattern pieces, skipped the twist, sewed the hem, turned it wrong sides together, matching up the neckline and arm side raw edges, then attach the neckband and sleeves to enclose those edges. The fabric is a little itchy, not really on the wrong side, but where the seam allowances are, the raw edges can be scratchy. You can't easily serge the raw edges of the front twist after it's sewn unless you did them in a single layer, and I didn't want to stretch the fabric, so I didn't want to serge the individual raw edges. That meant I had unfinished seam allowances that were touching my skin and were scratchy. Not to mention, the fabric is slightly sheer. The sleeves are unlined, so you might be able to see just how opaque the fabric is on me, but lining it just ensured that it would be comfortable and not too showy. The fabric is from Joanne. It's described as the perfect special occasion fabric for dancewear, skirts, gowns, and fashion accessories like scarves and belts. Measuring 43 inches wide, this dotted apparel fabric has a blend of 83% nylon and 17% metallic. Available in a wide range of sleek metallic colors, it's an ideal choice to create stylish apparel for fun occasions that need some extra shine and glamour. I talked about this fabric in my How to Sew with Halloween Fabrics video, explaining how I set up my sewing machine and ironing station to work with this fabric as well as 4 others. The top is really cute untucked, and you're just going to have to take my word for it for now. I'll be using this top for another video very soon where I'll show you how to style it for all the winter holidays, including Halloween, Christmas, New Year's, and Valentine's Day. For Halloween, I styled it with a super cute Day of the Dead inspired headband, a bouquet of glitter tipped black roses, fishnet stockings, and sparkly heels. If any of these items are available online, I will have a link to where you can purchase them in the description box. I am very careful not to call this a costume because I'm not really dressed up as anything, just dressed according to a theme. I love to have themed outfits for special occasions like sporting events, festivals, and parties. Halloween is really no different. So even if you aren't really into costumes like me, you can still have fun with the holiday. I hope you like my outfit as much as I do and are inspired to do something, even small, for Halloween this year. That's going to do it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!